Seibel, Jordan Kern, Garrett Berger, and Dawson Brandt.
Hello and welcome back to Kent and Judith Miller Stadium here to begin the 2023 football campaign for the Westminster Blue Jays. I'm Aaron Mosier with you as the Rhodes College Lynx out of Memphis, Tennessee travel in for this season opener for both squads. Again, Westminster 1-9 a year ago. Tumultuous up and down season with plenty of adversity to go along with it. But fresh new beginnings along with a fresh new bleacher and press box set. Generous donations from Kent and Judith Miller funding those. Rhodes 5-5 a year ago, 3-3 in the Southern Athletic Association. They blew out the Blue Jays in Memphis a year ago. But again, new season, new chance for so many of these Blue Jays. Plenty of notable departures on both sides. But it does give new opportunities for guys like Keegan Seibel, who tore his ACL 4 days into training camp last season and could not play that season as the starting quarterback. But now he'll get to lead the Blue Jays today. We'll have opening kickoff before we get to that point. Mid-80s, clear skies here in Fulton, Missouri. Just a little bit of wind. And the Rhodes College Lynx have elected to receive. And it will be Westminster kicking off from right to left. Austin Smith and John Hampton back to return for the Lynx. And the new kicker this year for Westminster, after so many special teams issues a year ago, it's Hugo Hover. Transfer from Central Methodist, was on the Eagle soccer squad in 2021, but now have a chance to kick the pigskin as he has it teed up, and we are about ready to go here in Fulton, Missouri. Westminster in their powder blue uniforms, Rhodes in the all whites. Hover puts his right foot into it, and we are underway in 2023. Smith bobbles it inside the five, recollects on the goal line, runs down the middle of the field, swerves to the left side, breaks a tackle, gets to the 10, to the 15. Then he is dragged down out of bounds. Mark him down at the 17-yard line. A little trouble receiving the opening kickoff, but able to recollect and get back to the 18-yard line.
17-yard return.
So that's where Rhodes College will take over, led by Rich Duncan in his third season at the helm. Houston Wilhelm out of Collierville, Tennessee, just to the east of Memphis, gets the start here at quarterback, replacing Luke Macias, but Wilhelm did get a lot of playing time last year. Shotgun, three wide receivers, and quick hands off to the right, off tackle up the middle of the field and down the hash is to Tez Knox, who only had 10 rushes a year ago. He's brought down after a medium game to the 21-yard line, or make that the 26-yard line now. Right hash, just underway here in Fulton, Missouri.
Second and three.
So many new faces, some familiar ones though on the Westminster defensive line. Devin Miller, Marcus Stevens. Now on the pistol is Wilhelm with Knox behind him. Wilhelm takes the snap and whistles blow.
Penalty on the play.
And Rhodes will take an early timeout. Second down and three to go. We'll keep it right here with you with that early timeout. And Rich Duncan leading this Rhodes College squad. A very experienced coaching staff on both sides, but especially with the Rhodes College Lynx. Rich Duncan, over 20 years of experience. Matt Cobb, 29 years of experience. Defensive coordinator Andrew Chow has been at multiple stops, including Culver Stockton. So this is a very experienced coaching staff at Rhodes College, one of the more highly regarded academic institutions in the country. Come out of the timeout. Alex LeBlanc, wide receiver on the near side. Line up against Logan Blicken, one of the returning secondary members. Wilhelm in the pistol. Three wide receivers set. Knox to the right. Mobilum, he takes the belt high snap. Takes out a defender, rushes to the left. Gets out of the pocket and scrambles ahead. And he slides right near the first down line. They'll give him the first down. He's down at the 29-yard line. So move the chains for Rhodes. Houston Wilhelm showing a little
Houston
bit of wheels
Wilhelm
there. He had 29 passing attempts a year ago, 21 for 29 yards, 20 for 21 for 29 in his attempts, 214 yards and a touchdown through the air for the 6 foot sophomore. Now it's Iman Larasabi, wide receiver here, the near side in the trips. Four wide receivers set, and they put Eli Chaddock in motion right to left, the tight end. Now the shotgun handoff to Knox off the left hash. It rushes outside and it is blown up at his legs after a gain of three.
Knox on the carry.
Mark him down at the 32-yard line. Brings up a second down. About second down and seven to go on the opening drive for the Rhodes College Lynx. Just underway here in Fulton. 13 minutes to play in the first quarter. LeBlanc, the receiver here to the near side with Andrew Pickens in the slot. Wilhelm takes a shotgun snap, looks to his right, now flush out to his left and fires downfield, complete to the tight end, check down the left sideline, the 45-40, and he's across midfield, then into Blue Jay territory. That's where he's brought down at the 40-yard line. Wilhelm just flips the field, rolls out to his left and fires downfield to his tight end, and Rhodes quickly set again. Wilhelm in the pistol, knocks behind him. Three wide receivers, and Chack the tight end, handoff to Knox. No, it's a play action, roll out to the right, firing downfield is Wilhelm, and it's incomplete at the 20-yard line. A late penalty flag comes out.
Pass incomplete.
Austin Smith, the wide receiver, running the route, and Logan Blicken in coverage. The flag lands at the 22-yard line. And a very intriguing pass interference call on Logan Blicken, to say the least. And so that will move up Rhodes to the 25-yard line, left hash.
First down, Rhodes.
12-21. Let's play the first quarter. No score here between Westminster hosting Rhodes here in their new look bleachers and stadium. Liam Conroy out of Tampa, Florida, checks into the game for Rhodes in the huddle. Four down linemen for Westminster, still playing the 4-2-5. Wilhelm in the shotgun with Knox motioning to his right. He takes the belt tie snap, handoff to Knox up the middle, and he trips forward for a moderate gain, about three. It brings up second down and seven to the 22-yard line. So the penalty moved Rhodes up to the 25. In Westminster territory, second down and seven to go in the middle of the field as they slow it down a little bit after hustling down the field after that completion to Eli Chaddock down the sideline. Wilhelm in the pistol, three wide receivers. Knox motions to the right of Wilhelm. He takes the snap, fake handoff to Knox, he drops back, fires and lobs it towards the end zone to the left, and it's complete on the far side for a touchdown. Far side of the end zone, complete to Iman Larasabi. We'll make that Andrew Pickens. Three touchdowns a year ago. 559 yards receiving. And he gets Rhodes on the board on their opening drive in 2023. Houston Wilhelm, the sophomore, looking as comfortable as ever after the play action, had plenty of time in the pocket and delivered a beautiful ball for a touchdown. So now Rhodes will set up for the PAT. Coleman Clay out of Mountain Brook, Arkansas to attempt it. Snap is good, the hold is good, and the kick is through the uprights. So with 11:35 to play in the first quarter, Rhodes takes an early 7-0 lead over Westminster. So about as good as you could ask for if you're Rhodes to start their season. Nice completions by Houston Wilhelm in his first start. He replaces Luke Macias, who threw for 14,000 yards. make that 1,400 yards, five touchdowns a year ago for Rhodes. Who again went 5-5, defeated Westminster a year ago 56-6, and led 56-0 through three quarters. So anything better than that is what Westminster is hoping for today. Holman Clay has it teed up, moving left to right for the Lynx. Elijah Teal back to receive for Westminster. Clay puts his foot into it, and an end-over-end kick is caught at the 14-yard line. Teal takes it down the far sideline and towards the hash, and he is brought down after a short return to the 25-yard line.
Westminster will start at the 25-yard line.
So now it's up to Keegan Zeibel to try to answer against this Rhodes defense that is ultra-talented. This is really the strength of the Rhodes team, allowing just 17 opponents points per game a year ago. Jordan Kern, Dante Billups, the running backs in the pistol along with Keegan Zeibel. Zeibel claps his hands, takes the belt tie snap, handoff to Kern up the middle, trucking ahead for a gain of three. That'll bring up a second down and seven at the 28-yard line on the right hash. Westminster moving right to left. Jordan Kern, 121 carries a year ago, 492 yards, two touchdowns. Brandon Perry, a new wide receiver for Westminster, lined up alone here to the near sides. Same formation with the running backs Billups and Kern. Kern lined up behind Zeibel. He takes a snap and hands it off to Kern, and he is quickly met in the backfield, did not even get back to the line of scrimmage. Min Yang,
Kern on the carry.
The graduate senior out of Arlington, Virginia, brings down Jordan Kern before he could even get started. That brings up a third down and eight at the 28-yard line. As they give him right around the line of scrimmage where Kern got back to. Kern checks out of the ball game along with Bryce Westerfield, is now playing tight end this season. Trey King and Elijah Teal, the wide receivers, the near side. Four wide receivers set for Westminster. Zeibel in the shotgun with Billups to his right. Middle of the field, third down. Belt tie snap, Zeibel looks to his right and fires, and it is incomplete at the 35-yard line. Dangerously lofted towards Brandon Perry there on the far side.
Broken up by Hart Penfield.
Lynx almost should have had that interception. Dangerously floated ball. Thankfully for Westminster, it falls incomplete, and so that will bring out Dawson Brandt to punt. He had to punt a lot last season, 61 times. He averaged around 35 yards per punt. He takes the snap. And it's an end-over-end kick that will bounce at the 39. Check up, and it's returned by Pennington. He runs down the near sideline and gets out of bounds at the 44-yard line in Westminster territory. Cooper Pennington on that return, and so that sets up Rhodes with a short field. Not a terrible punt by Brandt, but did not get the bounce that he really wanted. 9:49 to play in this first quarter. Rhodes leading 7-0, getting ready to take over for their second offensive possession of the day. They only scored 20 points per game a year ago, so they weren't exactly a prolific offense, but they definitely moved the football down the field on Westminster last season. Wilhelm in the shotgun with Knox to his left. They motion Conroy to the left and a handoff to Knox down the right hash, and he is brought down almost in the backfield. He tries to reach forward to get back to the line of scrimmage, but a really nice stop by Devin Miller, getting right in there along with JoJo Lozano, new transfer from Iowa Wesleyan, several new Iowa Wesleyan pieces that have joined this team since the Tigers athletic program shut down. So a loss of one, second down and 11 from the 45 on the right hash. Rhodes moving left to right, leading Westminster 7-0. Wilhelm in the shotgun, Knox to his right. Takes the belt tie snap, handoff to Knox, trying to go off tackle, he slips, and he loses more yards. Dawson Brandt, first team all UMAC a year ago on the defensive side of the ball, in there to get credited with the tackle for loss. And that'll bring up a third down and long from the 48-yard line. Third down and 14 officially. 8:47 and ticking in the first quarter. It was Wilhelm who found Chaddock on the last drive to really leapfrog the Lynx down the field. Brent Barlow, the wide receiver of the near side. Four wide receiver. Devin Miller almost jumps offside. Snap to Wilhelm. Plenty of time in the pocket. Fires down the middle of the field. Looking, and it's incomplete. Deep looking for his wide receiver, Hart Penfield. Inside the five-yard line is where it falls incomplete. They try to break open this Westminster secondary down the seam. And Wilhelm just a little bit too much juice on the football. So it brings up a fourth down and long. Fourth down and 14 again from the 48-yard line. Houston Wilhelm stays in the game, lined up deep to punt. Elijah Teal stands at the Westminster 10-yard line to receive this punt. Whistles blow. And John Welty wants to take a timeout. And we'll take a timeout with him. 8:23 left to play in this first quarter. Rhodes leads 7-0.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Welcome back to Kent and Judith Miller Stadium. Fourth down and 14. Rhodes at the 48-yard line of Westminster, and they're getting ready to punt it away with 8:23 left to play in the first quarter. They lead 7-0, and Houston Wilhelm, the quarterback, knocks a punt, and it bounces at the 16-yard line, and it trickles towards the middle of the field and inside the 10-yard line. A beautiful one from Wilhelm. Got a very friendly Rhodes bounce inside the 10 and they'll mark it at the 8-yard line. And so Westminster will take over for their second offensive possession deep in their own territory. So a penalty on the Westminster receiving team. Callan Topliff gets credited with it, the transfer from Iowa Wesleyan. And so that's going to push back Westminster even further inside their own territory. At the 3-yard line, left hash. Long way to go here for the Blue Jays. Moving right to left. Keegan Zibel getting his first start at QB for the Blue Jays. They went 3 and out in their opening drive. Dante Billups line up to his left. Jordan Curran behind Zibel. Standing in his own end zone. Zibel claps, takes the belt tie snap, drops back to throw, looks to his right, and fires out of the backfield. It's Jordan Curran with the grab to the 15-20, and he's brought down at the 25. A beautiful play drawn up by the Westminster Blue Jays. A dump out to Jordan Curran. Out of the backfield, nobody home for Rhodes to the flats. And so that sets up Westminster at the 25-yard line on the right hash. 7:48 and ticking in the first quarter. Jordan Curran not used a ton as a receiver last season, but gets a nice gain there on his first catch of the 2023 campaign. Same formation, two wide receivers. Zibel in the pistol. Takes the belt tie snap, drops back, looks to his left. Now flushed out, completes it to Dante Billups at the 30-yard line on the near side, and he is dragged down by a couple of lengths. Hart Penfield there in coverage.
Gain of 5.
Short gain. After a couple of completions to the running backs, a new look, a new twist to the offense this season. Second down and 5 on the 30-yard line on the left hash. Westminster moving right to left. Aiden Campbell, the wide receiver on the near side, Perry to the far side. Same formation with the two running backs. Four down linemen for the Lynx. Zibel takes the snap, drops back, rolls to his right. Cramley out of the pocket, throws it downfield, and it's errant. Too high, falls incomplete, out of bounds at the 40-yard line, looking for Brandon Perry. and he was wide open.
Pass intended for Brendan.
The transfer out of Missouri Baptist. A golden opportunity for Zybel to get an easy completion down the field, and he just overthrows it. So that brings up a second down and 5. .643 remaining in the first quarter. Rhodes leading 7-0 over Westminster. 4 wide receivers now, 3 in the trips to the far side. Snap is to Zybel. He rolls to his right, out of the pocket, trying to escape. Rolls downfield and is going to try to run past the line of scrimmage. And he steps out of bounds right at the 31-yard line. So Westminster cannot convert that third down.
Run by Zybel. Goes for 1 yard.
They only converted 23% of third downs last season. And at least this time they do move down the field and get their first down. But now they'll have to punt it away for the second time here in 2023. Dawson Brandt lined up to punt. Cooper Pennington back to receive for Rhodes. Bounce snap to Brandt, and he puts his foot into it. A wobbler, and it bounces at the 35 and into the hands of Pennington. He has a little trouble with it. Collects it on the far side. Runs down the sideline. Cuts up midfield and is brought down at the 42-yard line of Rhodes.
Pennington's return tackled at the 42-yard line. First down, Rhodes.
So Rhodes will set up shop once again. After having some issues on their last drive, getting past the line of scrimmage, Westminster's defense really stood up and stuffed the run. Now it's Elijah Bain checking in at running back for Rhodes, junior out of Knoxville, Tennessee. 3 wide receivers as whistles blow. So we reset the game clock to 5:45. Rhodes with the football on the left hash, moving left to right. Leading 7-0 over Westminster. Motion Chaddock left to right is Wilhelm as he takes the snap and hands it off to Bain up the middle. And he is dragged down after a gain of 2. Dawson Brandt in there on the stop. Brings up a second down and 8 on the 44-yard line. Credit Westminster, they're really stepping up in the run game early in this one. Defense really was not the problem for Westminster a year ago. Actually one of the better ones in the UMAC. Only second in the conference in both opposing yards per game and rushing yards per game. Wilhelm takes the belt tie, snap fires to his left, and it's complete on the far side to Andrew Pickens, and he gets out of bounds right near the line to gain across midfield to the 48.
Flag on the play.
There's a penalty flag down. So roughing the passer on Devin Miller, and that will give Rhodes some free yardage. There's a pass interference on their opening drive that really helped them out. And kind of deja vu here as they're driving once again with the help of the penalty. 33-yard line, left hash. 5:03 and ticking in the first quarter. The Lynx lead 7-0 over Westminster here in Fulton, Missouri. Elijah Bain, the running back behind Wilhelm. 3 wide receivers and a trip to the near side. Now the motion Chaddock right to left, the tight end. Snap to Wilhelm, he drops back, fires over the middle, and it's incomplete. Good coverage by Dylan Farrell. Ball's incomplete at the 23-yard line. He was looking for Alex LeBlanc.
Pass intended for Andrew Pickens. Farrell in coverage.
Dylan Farrell, one of the more experienced members of this Westminster defense. 31 tackles, an interception a year ago. So brings down second down and 10 from the 33-yard line. And the pistol is Wilhelm. Bain motions to his left. Wilhelm takes the snap, handoff to Bain, up the middle, squirts through to the 30, breaks the tackle, still on his feet, gains the first down a little bit more to the 22-yard line, down the left hash. Elijah Bain showing a little bit of balance and toughness running inside. 128 carries a year ago, 428 yards, and five touchdowns. Now a junior, 5'10", 190 is where number 24 is listed at. So first down and 10 on the 22-yard line, left hash. 4:08 in, ticking in the first quarter. Rhodes with the football, driving again. Bain motions to the right of Wilhelm. He takes a snap, handoff to Bain, motioning, running out to the left. Out of the off tackle, and he rushes ahead down the sideline and out of bounds. Rather, they say he's inbounds, they'll run the clock.
Bain on the carry, gain of 7.
He gains a medium portion of 7. Bringing up a second down in 3. On the 15-yard line. Three wide receivers all in tight next to the offensive line. Wilhelm in the pistol, takes the snap, handoff to Bain, off left tackle, slips momentarily, and then is brought down by a host of Blue Jays. Mark him right near the line of scrimmage again. Might have gotten close to the line to gain. It looks like they'll make it third down and short. Third down and one, or maybe inches. Ball on the 13-yard line, left hash. Big third down, an opportunity for the Westminster defense to stand up. Tez Knox checks back into the game for Rhodes. Conroy, the fullback, back in, and they've got a special setup here with Jake Duncan getting ready to take the snap. Jake Duncan takes it. High snap, rolls to his left, a little trouble, fires towards the end zone, incomplete, out of bounds, looking for Andrew Pickens, who is tightly covered by Logan Blicken.
Pass incomplete, intended for Pickens.
A little trouble with Logan the snap Blicken. Duncan did have, and he fired a southpaw towards the end zone and fell incomplete. Brings up a fourth down and one. Rhodes keeps the offense on the field.
Fourth down, Rhodes.
Jake Duncan is the son of head coach Rich Duncan. Mostly plays in the linebacker position, but he stays in this special formation. Tez Knox behind him. Fourth down and one. He takes the snap at the 13. Handoff to Knox. He drives ahead, and it's going to be close. A Blue Jay almost had him in the backfield. That was Dinkin Stedman. The transfer almost had him for a loss. Let's see if they give him the first down or not. It was right towards the 11-yard line. Make that the 12. And let's see if they will bring out the chain gang to measure this one out. It was awful close. He broke one tackle, Knox did. And then right towards the line to gain, they stretch it out. And it's going to be short. The Westminster defense stands up and picks up a big stop on fourth down. Rhodes was driving down the field, and then they try to get a little tricky with some different formations and different options. And it does not work out. So Westminster's offense will take back over with 2:10 left to play in the first quarter. They trail 7-0 here against Rhodes. Season opener, home opener for the Blue Jays here at the new look Kent and Judith Miller Stadium. So Keegan Zibel returns to the field for his third drive and his first start at quarterback. Jordan Curran, the running back, to his left in the shotgun with four wide receivers, three in a trips on the near side, including Brandon Perry and Aiden Campbell, along with Elijah Teal. Zibel in the shotgun. Takes the low snap, rolls out to his left, looking downfield, and is going to try to run and gain a few yards, and is punched out of bounds by Luke Papey, the junior out of Fairview, Tennessee. And so Zibel trying to look downfield to keep his eyes downfield, and rushes ahead for a gain of 3, second down and 7. Zibel showing a little bit of the athleticism he has. Under 2 to play in the first quarter. Trey King, the wide receiver on the near side. Now with the trips of the same members to the far side for Westminster. Kern to the right of Zibel. Three down linemen for Rhodes. Zeibel takes the snap. Looks down the middle of the field, steps up, fires it, lofting it down the middle. Oh, and it's incomplete at the 45, and a flag comes out. Evan Byrne in coverage on Aiden Campbell. A deep ball from Zeibel showing a little bit of the arm strength. A pretty good ball, gave Campbell a shot at it, and Evan Byrne just leapt over and kind of got an over-the-back penalty as if it was basketball. Byrne, second-team all-defense member in the SAA a year ago with 53 tackles and an interception, six pass breakups as well. But the penalty on him will allow Westminster to move up to the 31-yard line, moving right to left. And they're now on their left hash on their own side of the field. Same formation again with Kern to the right of Zeibel. Zeibel claps, and everybody jumped a little early there.
Penalty on the play.
So false start on Westminster. We'll move him back 5 yards. And there were many such occasions last season where Westminster really shot themselves in the foot and sometimes hurt themselves more than what the opponent did. Same formation again, four wide receivers with the trips to the far side. Zeibel in the shotgun, he takes the snap, rolls to his right, and he's going to flip it out to Kern in the backfield. Is this a fumble or an incompletion? And seems like they mark it as a fumble, and the ball's going to be all the way back at the 20-yard line. Jordan Kern able to fall back on it. A Lynx defender broke open freely and got pressure on Zeibel early. And Zeibel just tried to fling the football away dangerously. Would have been better for him to just take the loss. Brings up a second down and 15, so it does look like they're going to say that ball went forward and they're going to count it as a pass. Elijah Teal exits the field. Aiden Campbell, the wide receiver, the near side as the Blue Jays break the huddle. Trailing 7-0 here against Rhodes. Dante Billets back into the game to the left of Zeibel. Kern behind number 8 in blue as well. Zeibel takes the low snap, drops back. Looks to the left, now flush in the pocket, he's going to get dropped. Dropped for a loss anyway. The Rhodes pass rush heated up that time.
Zeibel sacked by number 32, Jason Kusabob, third down.
Jason Kusabob, one sack a year ago, picks up his first of this season, and that moves Westminster back. Third down and 25 to go. 43 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Ball in 16, a huge loss in that play for Westminster. And now they need to answer prayer to convert this first down. This third down, I should say. Brandon Perry and Aiden Campbell, the wide receivers on the near side. That's where Zeibel rolls initially, but now he's going to get dropped again. Three rushers as the Rhodes pass rush is heating up. And they drop him at the 5-yard line deep into Westminster territory. And Dawson Brandt out to punt. Let's see if they'll let the clock run out in the first quarter. That is what it appears to be. End of the first quarter, Westminster will have to punt out of their own end zone when we come back to you with the second quarter of action. Rhodes leading 7-0 after Westminster's offense sputters. I'll be back after this.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Welcome back to Fulton, Missouri. Long fourth down and a punt upcoming for Westminster. on their own 6-yard line. Now moving left to right, trailing Rhodes 7-0. Fourth down and 35 on their own 6. Dawson Brandt back to punt in his own end zone with his feet right at the end line. Cooper Pennington back to return at the 50. A low, short punt. Pennington receives it at the 36. Rushes from the left side, inside the 25 to the 20. Down the near sideline and out of bounds. Such a short punt, and there was nobody home with the Westminster coverage team, and he's able to get all the way to the 16-yard line. About as good field position as you could ask for if you're Rhodes. They scored on their opening possession, then stalled on their second, and then could not convert a fourth down and short on their third one. But now an even tougher test for the Westminster defense. First down and 10 at the 16-yard line for Rhodes. Houston Wilhelm returns at quarterback. Brent Barlow with the receiver on the near side. Handoff. No, Wilhelm keeps it himself on the read option and is brought down at the line of scrimmage. Dawson Brandt just continues to show his ability from the linebacker position to penetrate and get into the backfield. Loss of one. Tez Knox on the carry. I make that Wilhelm as they fake the handoff to Knox. Jake Duncan returns to the game. A senior out of Oswego, Illinois. Elijah Bain, running back to his left, split backfield. As he takes a snap, looks to his left, rolls to his left. Duncan loses the football, ball to turf, and he gets back on it at the 30-yard line. Now a penalty flag comes out late. My goodness, Jake Duncan just lost the football out of his left hand.
Jake Duncan flying on the play.
Felt like the football stayed on the turf for an eternity, but there was not a single Blue Jay available to recover it. So they pick the flag up for unnecessary roughness. Nothing against the Blue Jays. And now a third down and long for Rhodes at the 29-yard line on the left hash. And they're breaking in a new kicker this year. Coleman Clay, we'll see what his range looks like if we eventually come to it. Jake Duncan still in the game. Elijah Bain behind him. Knox to his right. Alex LeBlanc, the wide receiver, the near side. Third down and 23 from the 29. Duncan takes the snap. Penalty flag out. Could be a free play. Deep shot to the near side. It's picked off by Dylan Farrell in the end zone. But this could be an offsides on Westminster, which would be devastating because that was a really nice play by Dylan Farrell in coverage on Pennington. Make that LeBlanc. Man. And offsides on Westminster will give Rhodes new life. Extra 5 yards. So that moves into the 24 on the left hash. Still third down and long, third down and 18. 13:38 left to play in the first half. Rhodes leads Westminster 7-0. Four wide receivers, Duncan in the pistol. Bain to his left. Looks to the sideline. Westminster shows blitz, does not, brings four. Duncan takes the snap, rolls to his left, looking downfield with his eyes up, and it is incomplete. Bobbled between Aaron Cooper and the Blue Jay defender, Deacon Stedman, who had tight coverage, almost had the interception again as Rhodes continues to play a dangerous game, throwing it down the field. Coleman Clay out to attempt this field goal. It'll be about 35, 36 yards. Ball on the 24-yard line, left hash. Play sets up. His hold is good. The kick fluttering. Oh, it gets through. Just tailed off the goalpost and flies through. Just dribbles through. Coleman Clay had just enough distance to put it through, and Rhodes leads 10-0. Credit Westminster for even holding them to a field goal attempt after having to start that drive backed up, trying to defend 16 yards. But some miscues from Jake Duncan and the Rhodes offense stalls that drive. So 13:29 left to play in the first half. Rhodes leads Westminster 10-0. Coleman Clay gets set to kick this away. So make that Evan Reeder, who's been the quarterback that's come in. A little bit of a quarterback battle with Houston Wilhelm after Wilhelm really started this game well. Evan Reeder, the sophomore out of Hoover, Alabama. Now we get a new football out to tee up for Coleman Clay. Rhodes kicking right to left, leading Westminster 10-0 with 13:29 left to play in the first half. Season opener for both teams. Home opener for Westminster. Elijah Teal back to return for the Blue Jays. Clay puts his foot into it. Teal will take it inside his own 5, but he drops the football down inside the 15, and he's able to recollect and fall on it at the 13. Yeah, but more trouble in the special teams for both teams trying to return the football. So Westminster still looking for their first points of the season. Keegan Zibel has had some flashes of some good play, but Westminster's last drive stalled out. Brandon Perry, the wide receiver on the near side for Westminster. First action of the day for Trace Hessel, the running back behind Zibel now, with Dante Billups to his right. Zibel takes the belt tie snap, hands it off to Hassel, squirts through up the middle, has a pretty decent gain, about 5 yards. Mark him down at the 18-yard line. Brings up a first down and 5. Westminster moving on the right hash. Aiden Campbell, the wide receiver, the far side. Perry to the near side, 2 wide receiver set. Split backfield in the pistol. Zibel takes the snap, handed off to off left tackle, and Dante Billups rushes ahead for a short gain. Not too much going on that one. He gets past the 20 to almost the 21. So that'll bring up a 3rd down and 2. Mark him at the 21. Westminster staying on schedule to begin this drive. Same formation with Billups behind Zibel. He takes the snap, hand off to Billups. Same play call, run, powering ahead right towards the line to gain.
Billups on the carry.
And let's see if they give him the first down or not. And they do. They gave him the first down. Just enough for Dante Billups, the junior out of Mexico, Missouri. 11:50 and ticking. Left to go in the second quarter. Rhodes leading Westminster 10-0. Westminster with the football on their left hash. Zibel singling with his offensive line. And he'll take the snap and drop back. Looks to his left and fires. Incomplete, short for Barry. It falls down at the 40-yard line. It's a miscommunication when he was looking for Perry to run the out route. And Perry was running the go. Brings up 2nd down and 10. Zibel, the sophomore out of Slater, Missouri. Listed at 6'2", 185. Getting his first start at QB for Westminster after they went through Peyton Byerly, Bryce Westerfield, Reese Davidson, couldn't settle on anybody until Byerly at the end of the season.
Hassel to the left of Zybul. Four wide. He takes the snap on second down. Fires out of the backfield. It's Hassel at a 20. Gets the 25. Motioning ahead and bullying his way to the 29. Hassel brought down there on the far side. Brings up a third and manageable. Third down and five. As they continue to go to the running backs out of the backfield to give Zybul some easy completions. Aiden Campbell, the wide receiver on the near side for Westminster. Ball at 29 on the far side hash. Kern back in the game behind Zybul. Billups to the left is Zybul. Brandon Perry, the wide receiver, the far side. Zybul takes the snap, looks to his right, and fires to Kern out of the backfield. And he's not going to get very far. Bring him down right there at the 26-yard line.
Kern with the reception.
Group of links there to make the stop. Flag comes out late. Wow, what a back-breaking penalty for the Rhodes defense. You get the stop early in this drive, but now after the penalty, that'll move Westminster ahead. Move them up to the 42-yard line, still in their own half. Unnecessary roughness on Rhodes gives Westminster a breath of fresh air. 10:32 to play in the first half. Rhodes leading Westminster 10-0. Campbell, the wide receiver on the near side. Defended by Connor Young. Hand off to Kern up the middle and gained maybe two.
Kern on the carry.
Brings up a second down and eight on the near hash. Ball on the 44-yard line now. Zybul 4 for 9, 31 yards passing thus far today. Same formation with the split running back formation. Zybul takes a snap, takes it himself on the read option, and plunges ahead for a short gain.
Zybul on the carry.
Mark him down at the 46 and a half yard line. So it brings up third down and five. Still on their own half. 9:35 and ticking here in the second quarter. Trey King, the wide receiver on the near side, Brandon Perry and Aiden Campbell, along with Elijah Teal to the far side. Third down and five on the near side hash. Westminster moving left to right. Phillips, the running back to the left, is Zybul. He takes the snap, looks to his right, firing it downfield towards King. Tight coverage. Really well done by Nick Floyd, the junior out of Los Angeles. Some hand fighting. The ball falls incomplete at the 30 to the 25-yard line. Just really tight coverage. Gave Trey King almost no chance to get that football. And that's where the Westminster drive will stall. Dawson Brandt getting ready to punt it away for Westminster. Cooper Pennington stands inside the 15 on the Rhodes Lynx half. Fourth down and five, ball in the 46. Brandt takes the snap, puts his foot into it, end over end punts, and it will bounce up at the 25, received by Pennington inside the 20. Moves down the near side, now cuts towards the sideline to the 40. Still on his feet and down at the 45 is where he is tripped up. Mark him down at the 47-yard line on the Rhodes half. Cooper Pennington has done a very solid job here today returning the punts.
The Lynx take over at the 45-yard line.
He replaces Javon Cooper, who had a lot of kick return yards a year ago. Now Houston Wilhelm back into the game. Three wide receivers in the formation. Tez Knox moves to the right of Wilhelm. He takes the snap and fires complete quickly to Pickens, and he is dragged out of bounds. Into the Westminster half they go.
Pass complete to number 11, Andrew
Jeffrey Banks, the freshman in on coverage.
Second down.
He makes the tackle. That brings up a second down and two after the 8-yard gain. Now into Westminster territory on the 45-yard line, left hash. Pickens, the wide receiver on the near side, Eli Chaddick, the tight end to the left of the Rhodes offensive line. Knox to the right of Wilhelm in the shotgun. Motion for the Rhodes receiver as a handoff, off left tackle, and Knox trying to get ahead, and he is definitely not going to get much further than he did.
Knox on the carry.
Right near the lines
tackle
again.
Right, block of Blue Jays.
Gang tackling from the Westminster defense. And see if they give him the first down. They do. And he picks up 2 yards, and Rhodes continues the drive. 8:05 to play in the first half. Rhodes with the football, leading 10-0 over Westminster. Austin Smith and Alex LeBlanc, the wide receivers, the far side. Knox to the right of Wilhelm. He takes the snap. Wilhelm fires, looking for Knox, and it falls incomplete at the 42-yard line. Looking for Knox out of the backfield. There's a little bit of an errant, well, really a drop there by Knox.
Ricky Ellis in coverage.
Should have had that one. Ricky Ellis in coverage for Westminster. So ball still on the 43. On the left hash. Second down and 10 for Rhodes. Wilhelm, 4 for 8 today, 66 yards and a touchdown. Knox behind Wilhelm. He takes the snap, hands it off to Knox up the middle, and he runs right into the line that Westminster is really showing their strength in. They're dominating the line of scrimmage at the point of attack. Credit JoJo Lozano, a big part of that as he exits the field. They are replacing a bit of pass rusher depth with Rothman Harris and Justin Scales graduating. Third down and 9, ball on the 42. In the middle of the field, 7:03 to play in the first half. Wilhelm in the shotgun. LeBlanc, the receiver on the near side for Rhodes. He takes the snap, looks to his right, and then fires over the middle of the field to Austin Smith. He has the first down if they give him forward progress, and they do. He's eventually stopped by David Fenton.
Pass complete to number 1, Austin Smith.
Mark him down to 31.
David Fenton on the stop.
Ball in the middle of the field. First down for Rhodes as they continue to drive.
First down links.
It's been the passing game that has really given Rhodes their success offensively today. They haven't had much to do in the running game. Knox behind Wilhelm. LeBlanc and Smith, the wide receivers on the near side. Wilhelm takes the belt tie snap, looks to his left, fires that direction, complete to LeBlanc at the 20-yard line, and he is going to get dragged down by Deacon Stedman. Jeffrey Banks in on the coverage. And he gets inside the 20-yard line to the 18 on the near side. Brings up a first down for Rhodes inside the red zone. Ball on the left hash. Under 6 to play in the first half. The Lynx leading Westminster 10-0. LeBlanc, the receiver, the near side. Chaddick, Smith, and Pickens, the receivers, to the far side. Knox to the left of Wilhelm in the shotgun. He takes the snap, hands it off to Knox. No, he keeps it himself. And he is brought down from behind at the 20-yard line. Really nice job by the Westminster defensive line sniffing that one out. Devin Miller get credited with the tackle for loss.
Devin Miller on the stop. Loss of
had
one.
7.5 of those a year ago. Second down and 12. Ball on the 20-yard line, left hash. Continue to go to this pistol set. Umakoa Keloa, the wide receiver, checks in for Rhodes on the far side. Snap to Wilhelm. He drops back, looks to his left, completes it to Knox to the 20, and he gets inside towards the 15, out of bounds. At the 14 is where they mark him.
Pass complete to Knox. Dylan Farrell on the stop.
Third down at the 14-yard line. Third down and six. Ball on the left hash. Another opportunity for Westminster to hold Rhodes to a field goal attempt. Crowd getting into it just a little bit here in this new bleacher set at Ken and Judith Mueller Stadium. Third down and six at the 14-yard line. Wilhelm takes the snap, fakes, and then fires toward the far side of the end zone. It's complete to Austin Smith. Touchdown, Rhodes.
Farrell's pass complete to Austin Smith. Touchdown, Lace.
Houston Wilhelm, second touchdown of the day. Austin Smith just sprang open, running to the far side. A really nice ball. And Rhodes now leads 16-0 with 4:06 to play in the first half. Snap is good. The hold is good. The kick by Cole McClay is through the uprights. So Rhodes scores once more, and they lead 17-0. We'll take a break and be right back.
Cole McClay is good.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families. They work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree.
Welcome back to Fulton, Missouri. Rhodes leading 17-0, 4:06 to play in the first half. After the touchdown completion by Houston Wilhelm to Austin Smith, a freshman out of Collierville, Tennessee, the former teammates right there in southeast Shelby County. Coleman Clay getting ready to kick us off right to left. Elijah Teal, Brandon Perry back to receive for Westminster. Clay with the kick. Teal gets ready to receive it at the 7-yard line, takes it up the middle of the field, and then swerves left, breaks a tackle to the 20, and then is tripped up by the turf monster at the 22-yard line.
Elijah Teal on the return.
You can see his frustration. He was juiced up for that return. He had a really good chance. And then the turf monster got up and grabbed him. So Westminster takes over with 3:54 to play in the first half. They have two timeouts, but they trail Rhodes 17-0. Ball at 22. And the ball is on the left hash. Keegan Zibel has had some success, but the running game really hasn't gotten going for him to set him up for success. Brandon Perry, the receiver to the near side, defended by Jonathan Torres. Split backfield. Snap to Wilhelm Lowe. He recollects, looks down the middle of the field, now flushed out of the pocket, getting rushed down to the right, and he fires. Incomplete. Just gets rid of it. Nathaniel Pride was hunting him like a lion.
Pass is incomplete. Second down.
Seibel just able to get rid of it, and it brings up second down and 10. Second down and 10 from the 22-yard line. Left hash. Perry, the receiver, to the near side. Campbell to the far side. Split pistol look with Kern and Billups. Snap to Will to Zibel, and he fires complete to Aiden Campbell on the far side. First down. Complete to the 34-yard line. Make that the 33. And out of bounds goes Campbell. One of the few returning experienced receivers. 16 receptions a year ago for the Blue Jays. And that's a first down. A good ball by Keegan Zibel. Same formation. Zibel takes the belt tie snap. Looks over the middle of the field. Now flushed out to his right. Still trying to look downfield. And he's just going to float this one out of bounds again, getting rid of it. As the Rhodes pass rush still really getting through, Jason Kuzabov.
Second down.
And there with the pressure, the junior out of Chicago. Brings up another second down and 10. Ball to 33. 3:18 to play in the first half. Rhodes traveling in here from Memphis, Tennessee, leading 17-0 over Westminster. The Southern Athletic Association, they went 3-3 in conference play a year ago. Seibel takes the snap, fakes one handoff, then delivers to Kern, off left tackle, and out towards the boundary, and is brought down at the 37-yard line. Brings up a third down and medium. Trace Hessel returns for Westminster into the game. Kern checks out. Clock ticking under 3 minutes. Two wide receivers in the formation. Split backfield in the pistol. Third down and 7 from the 37. Left hash. Seibel takes the snap. Looks to his left. Now fires that direction downfield. Nobody home, and it is picked off at the 30-yard line by Taylor Haas. And he's going to run down the far side and is hang on his feet still. But they finally mark him down at the 41-yard line. Keegan Seibel throwing to approximately nobody into no man's land. It is the first interception for Seibel this season.
J.M. Sims.
So J.M. Sims, the safety, intercepts that one. The junior out of Lexington, Kentucky.
41-yard line.
Rhodes leading 17-0 after the interception by J.M. Sims. They line up in Westminster territory. Scored on their last drive with the connection from Wilhelm to Austin Smith in the end zone. Wilhelm back in the game. Four wide receivers in this set as he's in the shotgun. 2:19 to play in the first half. Motion, and then Wilhelm takes the snap, drops back, looks to his right, fires downfield, and it's complete at the sideline to the motioning receiver, Aaron Cooper.
Pass complete to number 80, Aaron Cooper.
He's got the first down for Rhodes, and they're at the 30-yard line on the far side hash. Colby Cook, the running back in the game to the right of Wilhelm. He takes the snap. Wilhelm fires complete to Aaron Cooper again towards the first down and driven out of bounds after an 8-yard pickup.
Pass complete to Cooper. Logan Blicken.
Logan Blicken with the tackle. Brings up a second down and short. Second down and 3 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. Brent Barlow. And John Hampton, the receiver, is the near side. Wilhelm takes the snap, flushed out of the pocket, gets the first down and more, rushing ahead to the 15. He's brought down at the legs by Deacon Stedman. Wilhelm picks up the first down.
Stedman on the tackle.
First down and 10 from the 15. Minute 35 and ticking in the first half. Rhodes does have two timeouts. Four wide receivers set, same formation. Wilhelm takes the snap, looks to his left, flushed out that direction, rolls to the left, and takes it himself, and is drilled shoulder first out of bounds, and some laundry out.
Wilhelm on the carry.
This is going to be a late hit out of bounds.
Flag on the play.
Tough penalty there on Eric Stevenson. Sophomore out of Memphis, Tennessee in Whitehaven High School. So that will likely set up Rhodes inside the 5. It's a tough play for Stevenson. He's just trying to make sure Wilhelm gets out of bounds, but they give so much protection to the quarterbacks.
First down Lynx.
Wilhelm was clearly trying to get out of bounds. And so that penalty will move Rhodes to the 7-yard line, first down and goal to go. And an 18 to play in the first half, the Lynx lead 17 to nothing over Westminster. 11 personnel, snap to Wilhelm, looks now towards the middle of the field, into the end zone, caught. Touchdown, Brent Barlow.
Brent Barlow with
the junior out of Oklahoma leaps up and makes the grab. There is a flag on the play. Oh, and a face mask on Rhodes will take away the touchdown and move them back. Maybe a face mask on one of the offensive linemen.
Penalty brings the Lynx backs to the 22-yard line.
Ball the 22-yard line, left hash. Still goal to go from here. Rhodes leading 17 to nothing, looking to add some more before the halftime break. A minute 13 to play. Cook to the right of Wilhelm, three wide receivers. Wilhelm takes the snap, rolls to his right immediately, and it's complete to Pennington. And make that Pickens, he's brought down. On the far side, out of bounds by Blicken.
Logan Blicken.
He's had a busy day defending the Rhodes wide receivers. And it looks like the Lynx will call a timeout. We'll take a timeout with them. 1:05 to play in the first half. Rhodes leads 17 to nothing.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Welcome back to Westminster. 1:05 to play in the first half. Rhodes leading 17 to nothing. Second down and goal to go from the 14. Ball on the far side hash. Wilhelm, the quarterback in the pistol with Elijah Bain moving to his right. Three wide receivers in the formation. Wilhelm takes the snap and now they're going to loop it around. And now a throw out of the backfield and it is incomplete. A little bit of trickery as they tried to toss it to Aaron Cooper on the reverse. He tried to throw it out on the Philly special, looking for Houston Wilhelm. It falls incomplete at the 2-yard line. Really good coverage there, defending Wilhelm. The Westminster Blue Jay getting out there to defend the pass. Well drawn up play out of the timeout for Rich Duncan and Rhodes. Offensive coordinator Matt Kolb calling up some trickery there. Third down and 14 to go. In the goal to go situation, far side hash. Wide receivers now in tight in a bunch. Wilhelm takes a snap, looks to the right. Now looks towards the end zone. Caught again on the far side. Touchdown, Rhodes. Connor make that Brent Barlow with his second reception for a touchdown today. He's had some tough grabs out there and a really nice start to the season for the junior. Rhodes leads 23 to nothing as Coleman Clay is ready to attempt the extra point. The extra point is up and it is good. 24 to nothing, Rhodes leads with 54 seconds to play in the first half.
Good.
Elijah Teal, Brandon Perry back to return this one. Squibber, and Teal has a little trouble with it, and he's going to get brought down at the 23-yard line.
The Blue Jays will take over at the 24-yard line.
Fifty seconds for Westminster to work with. Two timeouts as well. Zeibel looking over the middle, and the penalty flag should be out. There it goes. I mean, the referee was sitting right there at the 30-yard line, and thankfully, the back judge.
Flag on the play.
Finally throws the flag. Jake Duncan with his hands all over the Westminster defender, or the receiver. So,
first down.
Penalty will give Westminster another first down. Move him up to the 32-yard line. Zeibel looks to his left, now flushed out of the pocket to his right, looking downfield, takes it himself to the 35 and out to the 40. Zeibel able to keep it up, and now there's some flags out for something. Zeibel showing the ability to run out of the pocket and make something happen. That'll move Westminster back again. Already 7 seconds remaining in the first half now. Zeibel hand off to Kern, and he is brought down after a short game. And it appears that Westminster will be content at this point to run out the clock in this first half. Still have two timeouts left. And Zeibel. Flushed out of the pocket again, rolling to his left, and fires complete to Elijah Teal in the middle of the field. And he is brought down at the 35. Nice finish
pass
to the half
by Elijah Teal,
showing some athleticism.
That's the end of the second quarter.
But at the end of the second quarter and the end of the first half, Rhodes with a pretty dominant performance, and they lead 24-0. We'll take a halftime break, and we'll be back after this.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older. And they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. we're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that favors you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older. And they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that favors you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that favors you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older. And they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that prepares you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP course learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that prepares you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction from helping your clients directly. For example, as a financial planning professional, you'll help your clients in developing such personal financial plans as estate planning and retirement planning. Our curriculum also aligns well with the CFP Board's learning outcomes. Here at Westminster, you can also pursue a dual degree in financial planning and finance to further your career.
Today's typical college student is no longer the recent high school graduate. Almost half of all college students in the United States are age 24 or older, and they have busy lifestyles. They have families, they work part-time jobs or full-time jobs, and they want to earn a college degree. As you could imagine, the traditional college experience just doesn't work for them. Westminster College has a rich history of excellence in cultivating leaders. And now, we can take that experience beyond our campus. We're proud to announce the launch of Westminster Online. It's designed to be flexible and to meet your needs. This program runs in back-to-back 7-week sessions, so you can finish your degree faster. It's 100% online, so you can attend class on your schedule. You can choose to major in either business administration, organizational leadership, or in psychology. Westminster Online is affordable, and if you need to pause your studies, because life happens, you can do that. You're able to sit out a session and then come back when you're ready. Check out our website at wcmo.edu to learn more.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Financial planning is one of those careers that prepares you with your own professional accomplishment as well as a deep mental satisfaction.
Welcome back to Kent and Judith Mueller Stadium here in Fulton, Missouri. Dominant first half by Rhodes. Houston Wilhelm, their quarterback, 12 for 16. 151 yards and three touchdowns. And Cooper Brent Barlow, two touchdowns receptions. Andrew Pickens with one. I think that Austin Smith with one. Keegan Zeibel, 6 for 16. And 51 yards, an interception.
Get loud, it's time for the second half.
As we begin the second half of play, Rhodes leading Westminster 24 to nothing. Coleman Clay kicking right to left to get us back underway. Rhodes pretty much did what they wanted to in that first half, had plenty of short fields to work with. Elijah Teal will not receive that one. A good boot from Coleman Clay. Touchback out of the Westminster end zone.
Touchback. Westminster will start at the 25-yard line.
Westminster will take over at the 25-yard line. 51 yards through the air. 36 on the ground. Not much offense for Westminster. They've had a few first downs.
Let's go, let's go.
But Keegan Zeibel still trying to find his rhythm in his first start at quarterback for Westminster here in 2023. Brandon Perry, the wide receiver on your side. Split backfield with Kern and Billups, the running backs. And the pistol is Zeibel. Zeibel takes the snap, handoff. Dante Billups up the middle. And he is dragged down for maybe a gain of two. Mark him down to 27. Second down and eight to go. Second down and eight to go in the middle of the field. Zeibel takes a snap, fake handoff to Billups, then eventually gives it to Kern off left tackle, and he is brought down back to the line
Kern
of scrimmage. Third down and eight to go.
Third down, Blue Jays.
Third down and eight on the Westminster 27. Perry, Campbell, Teal, the receivers and the trips to the near side. Trey King all alone on the far side. Kern to the right of Zeibel. Low snap to Zeibel. He looks to his left and fires. Incomplete. Ball flies out of bounds at the 35. Looking for Trey King on the out route. Working one-on-one with Evan Bird and on the coverage. So fourth down and eight, and Dawson Brantz back out to punt. Four punts for 138 yards in the first half. Cooper Pennington back to receive it. Four returns for 77 yards. Brantz puts his leg into it. A spiral, bounces and checks up at the 50-yard line and then bounces back into Westminster territory out at the 48.
Punt is down at the 48-yard line.
Rhodes offense clicking mostly through the air. They haven't had much on the ground. 151 yards through the air. Just 31 on the ground on 17 rushes. Ethan Presley checks in the game as a tight end.
On the left of the Rhodes offensive line, Elijah Bain, the running back behind Wilhelm. Wilhelm takes a snap handoff to Bain, and he's not going to get anywhere. Still good defense from the Westminster defensive line holding up in the run game.
Run is shut down by a whole host of Blue Jays.
Connor Abshire also in the game, the senior tight end. Both him and Presley, the tight ends, in this formation with two wide receivers. Bain to the right of Wilhelm. Takes a snap on second down and looks and fires to his right, and it's complete to Bain. He makes one guy miss, makes another, runs up to the 40 towards the line to gain. And it looks like they'll give him the first down. Really nice run after the catch for Elijah Bain. Receiving the pass out of the backfield.
Bain
Martin
the
Fields,
catch.
The junior left tackle, will exit the first field down as his helmet came off. Conroy back into the game as a fullback slash tight end. 12 minutes to play in the third quarter. First down for Rhodes at the 37-yard line. Ball on the right hash. Timeout taken by Rhodes. They'll take it with him. Rhodes leads 24-0. Timeout. First down and 10 to go on the 37-yard line. Rhodes on the far side hash, moving right to left down the field. Conroy and Bain in the split pistol with Wilhelm. Wilhelm hand takes the handoff to Bain and then fires down the middle of the field. A little too far, incomplete at the 5-yard line. Looking for Andrew Pickens down the seam.
Pass intended for Pickens, ball's incomplete. Second down.
Second down and 10 on the far side hash. Off to Bain, off right tackle, rushing ahead and barreling ahead for a gain of 8, down to 29. Brings up a third down and 2 for Rhodes.
It's third down.
Rhodes was 3 of 6 on third down in the first half. Austin Smith in motion, left to right. Snap to Wilhelm, flag is out. Dump out to Bain, and he is brought down quickly. Brought down by Ricky Elias.
Bain tackled by Ricky Ellis. Flag on the play.
So offsides on Mike Pilar.
That's a first down for Rhodes.
So Rhodes gets a free set of downs. Ball now on the 24-yard line. Bain still the running back. And he takes the handoff. Bouncing heads. Helmet comes off for Lynx.
Bain on the carry. Tackled by Marcus Stevens.
Colin Seymour will have to exit. Conroy is in. They replace Chaddock. Second down and five from the 25-yard line. And make that the 26. Second down. Pickens and Smith, the running back, or the wide receivers to the near side. Wilhelm looks to his right, firing towards the far side of the end zone. Incomplete, out of bounds. Alex LeBlanc was his intended receiver. Good coverage again by Logan Blicken. If you had to give
Logan
any sort
Blicken
of consolation prize to today, it's him. He has had a very strong performance today, the junior out of Kirksville. Up a third down and six.
It's third down.
Rhodes converted 41% of their third downs a year ago. That was third in the SAA. Snap to Wilhelm. Fires quickly over the middle, complete to Smith, and he gets the first down down to the 11-yard line.
Austin Smith on the catch. Tackled by Dawson Brandt.
5'7" freshman, getting plenty of playing time early on. You can see the connection between him and his high school teammate, Houston Wilhelm. Back to the pistol, first down and 10 from the 11-yard line. Bain in motion out to the left. Wilhelm looks over the middle and rushes out to his left, scrambling, and gets out at the line of scrimmage. Good pursuit by Deacon Stedman and the Westminster defense. It's 9:20 to play in the third quarter.
Second down.
Wilhelm in the shotgun, he takes a snap handoff to Bain on the inside zone. He's rushing ahead and drags the Blue Jay defenders into the end zone.
Elijah Bain on the carry.
The judge quickly shuts down his
touchdown
celebration
Lynx
over there. First touchdown of 2023 for Elijah Bain. Point for Coleman Clay is right through the uprights. Rhodes leads 31-0.
Coleman Clay's extra point is good.
Museum Studies at Westminster is a program where students create and curate exhibitions, design programs, ask challenging questions, and above all, blend history, heritage, and culture in a way that informs and inspires. We invite you to join us at Westminster and be a part of history in a way that not only preserves the past, but through the power of museums, helps to build a better future.
Coleman Clay getting ready to kick us off. I think at this point, if you're Westminster, you're just looking for anything positive offensively. Such a dreadful year for them. Just trying to score last season and
Tough opponent here. Rhodes is very good defensive bunch.
And more trouble for Elijah Teal trying to return the kicks. And a penalty flag is out. See if this is a holding more laundry.
Flag on the play.
A sloppy play all around. Penalty on Westminster will back up their offense even more. So, special teams not exactly helping out their offense.
Blue Jays will take over on their own
first
10-yard
appearance
line.
Of the season for Kendall Outlaw, the fullback junior out of Lee Summit, Missouri. He gets in the lineup to the left of Zybul. Hessel sits behind Zybul. And off to Hessel. Off left tackle, and not much to do there.
Hessel
Cooper Pennington
the
there to help in on the stop. This Rhodes team did lose a fair amount from last season. Their starting quarterback, Michael Thomas, the running back, Javon Cooper, the wide receiver, replacing their kicker slash punter, Wiley Henshaw. Lost Deion King. Five tackles for loss from a linebacker position a year ago. Zybul dumps it out to Hessel, and makes a couple of guys miss. And there is just not much to go for him.
Zybul's pass complete.
Nate Bamakole in there on the stop
loss
for Rhodes.
Two.
Brings up a third down and long. Jordan McCoy was a first-team defense linebacker for Rhodes a year ago. Kobe Binns, 10.5 tackles for loss. Make that 16 tackles for loss and 10.5 sacks. He was on the first-team defense in the Southern Athletic Association. Penalty flag out. Too many men on the field for Westminster, and Kendall Outlaw will have to exit stage right. Backed up deep. And the Westminster half. We'll see if Albert Curran will let Keegan Zybul air it out a little bit on this third and long. On their own four. Bad snap, Zybul just has to take the safety. Brutal possession for the Westminster
safety
offense.
Safety on the play.
Lost nothing but yardage and 2 points. And Rhodes leads 33-0. Austin Brantz will punt this one away after the safety. End over end. Checks up at the 35 and then bounces into the hand of Smith. Smith cuts towards the middle of the field, slips, and is down at the 37-yard line.
Smith on the return. Connor Vaughn makes the tackle.
Comes Houston Wilhelm and the Rhodes offense back on the field. Elijah Bain with the touchdown run on their last drive. Cook stands behind him. Tez Knox in front of him to the left. Hand off to Cook. And he rushes outright. Plenty of space to the 50, and he is brought down at the 45-yard line. David Fenton.
Cook on the carry, tackled by Fenton.
David Fenton with the tackle. First down for Rhodes into Westminster territory now at the 45. And out to Cook again. And he is brought down at the line of scrimmage. Devin Miller wrapping
Devin
him up.
Devin Miller on the stop.
Devin Miller.
Cook running the ball.
One of the silver linings of today's game. The junior out of Paris, Missouri. 29 tackles, 4 sacks, a forced fumble a year ago for Westminster. Interesting choice as a defensive lineman to go from number 90 in the 90s to now number 11. Wilhelm in the pistol. And looks to his right, fires complete to Tez Knox. Wrapped up at the legs by Ricky Elias.
Pass complete to Knox. Elias on the stop. It's third down.
Elias, the junior out of Golden West High School in California. Third down and 5. Colby Cook to the left of Wilhelm. He takes the snap. And fires to his left, and it's intercepted! Intercepted by Eric Stevenson. Finally, something goes right for Westminster today.
Eric Stevenson on the interception.
He got called for that unnecessary roughness earlier in the first half. And he redeems himself there, intercepting Houston Wilhelm. Just a bad pass. And Eric Stevenson, a sophomore out of Memphis, able to get his first interception as a Blue Jay. See if the offense can do anything with a positive momentum. 4:57 to play in the third quarter. Rhodes leads 33-0. Zeibel with a little trouble in the snap and then is just brought down for a loss of 1. Starting to see some issues snapping the football. A little bit of some new looks on the offensive line, but Eli Shaw is one of the carryovers, the senior out of Mesquite, Texas. Nothing. Rhodes leads over Westminster. Westminster with the football, driving left to right. After the interception by Eric Stevenson, second down and 11 from the 34-yard line in their own half. Ball in the right hash. Shotgun snaps to Zeibel. And he fakes left and then rolls out to his right, looking downfield. Will take it himself. Grabbed at the legs, right back at the line of scrimmage.
Zeibel on the carry.
Max Sale with the tackle, the junior.
Third down, Blue Jays.
Brings up a third down and 11, or make a third down and 9 now. Ball on the 37-yard line. Make a 36. Trey King, the wide receiver on the near side, trips to the far side. Zeibel takes a snap, And it's a dribbler, and he has to fall back and recover inside the 20-yard line. More issues for Eli Shaw, snapping the football. Dawson Brant back to punt. Cooper Pennington to receive. Tail wagger by Brant is fair caught at the 49-yard line on the road's half by Pennington. So the Lynx will take over on the left hash. With 2:46 to play in the third quarter.
Fair catch by Cooper Pennington. Lynx take over at the 48-yard line.
Jesse Williams, the wide receiver to the near side. Motioning out Bain. And Evan Reeder completes it to him out of the backfield. And Bain is brought down after a medium-sized pickup. Ricky Elias hanging on to his legs. Deacon Stedman also in there on the stop.
8 of 5.
Second down and 5 from the 47. That's second down and 4. Bain, the running back behind Reeder. Reeder takes a snap, handoff to Bain to the left. Makes one man miss, bounces outside, and still on his feet, all the way inside the 40. And brought down at the 36. Dawson Brant in there on the stop.
Stop made by number 28, Ricky Elias.
Ricky Elias also in there. Evan Reeder, the sophomore out of Hoover High School, 6'2", 202 pounds. And he takes a snap and looks to his left and completes it short. Nice tackle by Eric Stevenson, who had the interception. Bringing down Jesse Williams, the 6'3 sophomore.
Jesse Williams, Stevenson on the stop.
Williams out of Bronson, Florida. Looks up a second down and 5. Trips to the far side for Rhodes. Evan Reeder fakes and then design run to the left, and he is, decapitated by Stevenson. The laundry is out. Stevenson is certainly laying the lumber here today. Callan Topliff was dragging him from behind, but that could be the end of the day for Stevenson, as they're going to help him to the bench and likely do some concussion protocol with him. Evan Reeder and his head taken off. Thankfully, he is okay. Looks like they're going to work on Stevenson's lower back, so. That's going to be targeting on Stevenson. After the interception, he is ejected from today's game. So So Rhodes set up in the red zone again. There are 3 for 4 in the first half in the red zone. Four of eight on third down is Rhodes. 23 minutes of time of possession. And Reeder will keep it himself and get drilled again.
Reeder on the carry.
This time by Brandt.
Brandt makes the tackle.
And the clock will run out here in the third quarter. Rhodes driving, and they lead 33-0. I'll be back.
The way we consume digital media in our world is constantly changing. The way we learn about it needs to change at that same pace. At Westminster College, we're putting you at the forefront of this interdisciplinary research by letting you experience firsthand some of these changes so you'll be better prepared to create it yourself when you leave our campus. In our labs, you'll experience cutting-edge technologies that will prepare you for a career in whichever sector of digital media that you're comfortable. You won't just hear about digital media, you'll experience it yourself.
Over at the 19-yard line. Second down and 6. Evan Reeder still the quarterback. They'll send Cooper in motion, and they will not hand it off to him. Reeder keeps it himself, breaks the tackle inside the 10. He dives.
Reeder keeps the football.
First down and goal to go from the 7-yard line. And off to Bain up the middle, bouncing and then staying on his feet. And not quite into the end zone. Stood up right there.
Bain carries the ball.
Brings up a second down and goal, and one to go. Design run, straight into the end zone, touchdown Rhodes. They lead 39-0.
Reeder on the carry. Touchdown Lynx.
Extra point is good by Clay. And Rhodes leads
play knocks 40 through the extra nothing. Point.
Museums allow us to celebrate humanity's soaring achievements while also providing lessons on how to avoid the mistakes of our past. They can also amplify the voices of underrepresented groups while bringing economic uplift to communities. We invite you to explore this world while finding a rewarding career by becoming a Museum Studies major at Westminster College.
Tail wagging or end over end kick from Clay. Oh my, what is going on? You have to receive the kick. And Rhodes will take over. There's complete malfunctions for the Westminster special team.
Recovered
unit.
By number 27, Max Sale.
Max Sale with the recovery. Steven Swoner now in the game, complete to Austin Smith, touchdown Rhodes. One play, touchdown for Swoner, the sophomore. 6'2", 200 out of Mount Juliet, Tennessee.
Touchdown Austin
and
Smith.
And his first college completion is a touchdown. The touchdown for Austin Smith. Is good this time by Miles Kruger. Freshman out of St. Louis and Kirkwood. Brandon Perry and Mikel McFarland out of Poplar Bluff, Missouri to receive this kick. Over end kick received by Perry. He can't collect it. Oh my.
Fumble is recovered.
And Westminster
by the Blue Jays.
Will start at the 21 yard line. Keegan Zybo. Zybo back in with Kendall Outlaw and Trace Hessel. Zybo looking over the middle. And he fires that direction. There to the far side, incomplete. blocking for Perry.
Pass is incomplete, intended for Perry. Second down.
In the shotgun. Hands it off to Hessel. Up the middle. And Hessel falls forward to the 28-yard line. Hessel, sophomore transfer from William Penn University, hometown of Mokane, Missouri. Ray King and Elijah Teal, the wide receivers, to the near side. Zybel takes the snap, rolls to his right, out of the pressure, and he's going to loft it downfield and over the head of Brandon Perry. Incomplete, brings up fourth down.
Pass intended for Perry, falls incomplete, fourth down.
A return for Dawson Brantz and the Westminster punting unit again. Lofty spiral to the 35, fair caught by Pennington.
Hunt is fair caught by Pennington.
To Lynx ahead to the 40. Swoner still in the game as the quarterback. Robert Daniel, the freshman, gets that handoff.
Tackle made by Toplin.
Daniel
on the
freshman
carry,
out of Murfreesboro.
Down.
Swoner, handoff. Right back to Daniel. He's out of bounds at the 50.
Daniel on the carry.
David Fenton with the stop.
From first down, Rhodes.
Koa Keloa, the wide receiver, to the near side. And off to Daniel, off left tackle, breaks through, and then is brought down by David Fenton.
Daniel on the carry.
Close to the first down, they'll bring up a second down and two. Owner handoff, Daniel cuts back up the middle of the field and has the first down. Brought down by Westminster linebacker Deacon Stedman.
Stedman with the tackle. Daniel carries the ball.
Gallen
first
top
down.
Lift replaces him. Swoner fires to the right, and it is complete. Logan Flicken on the stop. Kellen Gares with the reception. Freshman out of Albuquerque, New Mexico. Second down and six from the 35. Swoner hand off to Daniel, and he slips up. Maybe a gain of one.
Daniel carries the ball. Dylan Farrell makes the tackle.
It himself gets away from Topliff and then is brought down by Fenton, Brant,
tackle made by
and
Brant.
Devin Miller. Miller a little shaken up and he'll stay in.
Fourth down, Rhodes.
Fourth down and three, and Rhodes will go for it. Swoner drops back, looks in the middle, and fires complete to Daniel. He has the first down, takes a big hit, multiple flags out. His helmet
Daniel
goes flying out of bounds as well.
Flags on the field.
Banks gets the penalty. Keats LaFell, a new running back, and he takes that handoff and tackled by Brant at the legs. Wrapped up after getting
Spencer
back to the line of scrimmage.
Stop. Second down.
LaFell, the freshman out of Dallas, Texas, he gets. Does not get the hand up this time. Play action and a sack. Very nice tackle in the backfield by Mike Pilar.
Sack by number 18,
dropping
Sloaner
at the 25. Pilar, the freshman out of Houston, Texas, and North Shore High School. A lot of new faces, freshmen, and transfers on this roster.
Third down.
Third down and 22 to go for Rhodes. Ball at 25. Swinner takes a snap, looks to his right, now drops it off with a halfback screen. LaFell to the 20 and out of bounds. Or rather, it's brought down
in
bounds.
Penalty on the play.
Flag is out. Trying to set up the halfback screen. Holding is on Rhodes to see if Welty accepts it or not.
Holding on Rhodes.
And he will to back them up even further for a fourth down. For a third down again.
It's still third down.
Ball at the 35. Third down and 32 to go. Swoner roll out to the right. Pressure in the pocket, now fires it complete to his wide receiver at the 25-yard line. Will McGargy.
Pass complete, tackle made by Blicken.
Listed as a defensive back that makes that reception.
Fourth down Rhodes.
So now a long field goal attempt coming up for Miles Kruger, relatively long. 42-yard attempt upcoming for Kruger. Hold is good. The kick is up. And he pushed it wide right.
Kick
and
is, no,
is
good.
No good. So our score remains Rhodes 47, Westminster 0. So now Westminster has gone to Byerly. To get some snaps. He really did finish last year strong in that crown game, but he's had some struggles earlier in the year. Senior out of Springfield, Missouri and Kabul High School. Byerly and a false start on Westminster.
Flag on the play.
Trace Hessel a little frustrated with his teammates as he knew he was getting that handle.
Cornerback.
Amir Martin, the wide receiver, the near side. Brandon Perry's still in on the far side, but now he's going to get replaced by Peyton Olson, sophomore out of Camdenton. His former high school teammate, Kelton Virtue, showed some real promise at the tight end position a year ago, but he has since transferred from the program. Off to Hessel, bounces outside and is brought down after a short pickup.
Hessel on the carry.
Brought down at the 23-yard line.
Gain of three.
I'd like to see Welty maybe give, or Kern give Byerly some more chances to throw the football, because he really did do a good job in that crown game a year ago. Under 4.5 minutes to play in this one. Byerly the snap, handoff, and the ball's dropped. It has it. Who will come up with it at the bottom of the pile? It's Rhodes football.
Rhodes recovers the fumble.
Another turnover for Westminster today.
Number 28, Russell Jankowski recovered the fumble.
Four fumbles today now for Westminster. They have lost two of them now. Short field for another Rhodes quarterback, Tanner Now, the junior out of Raleigh, North Carolina. Robert Daniel sits behind him, but moves to his left, and a handoff to Daniel. Off left tackle up the middle of the field. And driving ahead, first down.
Daniel on the carry.
Brought down at 9 yard line. Now, handoff to Daniel. Back to the line of scrimmage.
Daniel on the carry.
Second down and 9 to go.
Tanner Nah in at quarterback.
Coming up for Rhodes is their home opener. They host Austin College. Keeper for Nall. And
Nall keeps the ball.
And they'll host Center College for taking their trip, probably their most difficult trip of the year at Trinity University. Trinity, really talented Division III program, and picked first in the SAA preseason. Next week, we'll be right back here. Westminster will host Sewanee. Kickoff set for 1 p.m. before they'll travel and have a bye week and then travel to Lyon and then Crown. False start on Daniel. They'll return home on the 7th of October to host Martin Luther. And then kind of a...
If you would like to meet your student athletes after the game, go to
this
the
year's schedule
parking
with
line.
Finlandia no longer existing as a football program, and Iowa Wesleyan also shut down. Two opponents that Westminster played last year. They have to play Minnesota Morris back-to-back weeks. First on the road, and then they
Daniel
host
on
them
the
on the 21st, and then they'll finish out their home schedule against Greenville on the 28th before traveling to take on Northwestern of Minnesota on the 4th of November.
Where's the parking lot? Thank you.
Thanks.
Minute and a half left to go on this opener. Rhodes looking to close it out with a touchdown. Played four different quarterbacks today. Daniel motions to the right of Now. Oh, and he gets rocked. He gets rocked after keeping it himself. Should have handed it off. Topliff right there to make the stop. Sophomore out of Fort Myers, Florida.
Number
turnover on downs
ball
will bring out Westminster's
tackle.
Offense for likely
over.
The last time today.
At the 13-yard line.
Farley returns with Hessel. And Caden Olson, the sophomore out of Farmington, Missouri, the transfer from University of St. Mary.
Number
Hand off to Hessel outside, and 2 yard gain.
Hessel on the carry.
Maybe one.
Gain of two.
Under a minute to play in this one. Houston Wilhelm with a good performance today, throwing the football. Rhodes had a lot of short fields to work with. They converted on their opportunities. One interception either way, a few fumbles for Westminster. Hessel pushes the pile forward to the 20-yard line.
Hessel on the carry.
Third down and medium.
Third down.
So we will see you next week against Sewanee. Second home game of the season. The season opener for Westminster is a loss.
That's the end of the
Rhodes
game.
Puts up 47, traveling in from Memphis.
Final score, Lynx 47.
They shut out the Blue Jays.
Blue Jays 0.
And that is the end of this
one. If you
one.
Want to meet your student athletes, please do so.
We will see you back here again next week.
Field,
we thank you
UNRO
for joining us
lot.
And tuning in. Rhodes with a convincing 47-0 victory here today. Signing off from Fulton. And with our Westminster crew, I'm Aaron Rozier. We'll see you next time.